Newswatch 12 at 4.
Two Grants Pass School District employees who were fired this past July for breaking school district's policies have been reinstated. Thanks for joining us on Newswatch 12 at 4 tonight. I'm Brian Morton. That decision came late last night after the school board voted 4-3 in favor of reversing its summertime decision. We're turning now to Newswatch 12's Brett Taylor, who is just in front of the North Middle School in Grants Pass. Brett, I know you've been out there for a while trying to figure out what the community's response is to this changing story. What have you found out?
Yeah, Brian, for the last several hours, I have been walking down the streets surrounding North Middle School, asking residents in the area on their response about how they feel about that school's reversal decision of firing two of its employees earlier this summer. Now, I talked to roughly about 15 residents in the area, most of which who were not comfortable going on camera, but all stating to me that they're 100% on board with this reversal. Now, everyone that I talked to as well said that the school district had no right to fire both of its employees. That's Rachel Damiano and Katie Medard earlier this summer because of a choice to express their opinions on how schools all across Oregon could address gender identification policy. Now, in a video that was posted all the way back in March, Damiano and Medard expressed several ideas on how schools could deal with gender identity policies, including creating bathrooms and locker rooms that are listed with anonymical male and female, meaning that no matter what you identify as, if you're biologically a boy or a girl, you have to use that specific bathroom. Now, one Grants Pass father that I spoke with today told me that he agrees with that type of model, and we'll have more on what he has to say coming up tonight on Newswatch 12 at 5. Now, with both faculty members reinstated, we still don't know when exactly they'll be starting their old jobs up back yet, but I did ask their lawyer earlier today if the lawsuit that they had filed against the school district was still going to be in place, even with their reinstatement. He did confirm to me that that lawsuit will still be continuing on. Reporting live in Grants Pass, I'm Brett Taylor, Newswatch 12.